I would like to address the issue that Google calculator thinks 1 divided by 0 is equal to infinity. That's not true, because 1 divided by 0 is undefined, meaning this right here has no answer because we cannot divide it by 0. But I know what Google is doing to get infinity for the answer, and let me explain. Here, as I just mentioned it, we cannot divide it by 0, so this is what Google did. It's not really divided by 0. Check this out. Let's make some observations. Instead of just give up, right? Let's start with say something. Let's say 1 divided by 1. And can we do this? Sure thing, the answer is just 1. Done. But now, I really want to get to 0. So maybe we can change this number to make it smaller, right? How about let's take a look at 1 divided by 0.1. Yeah. And if you work this out, you get 10. Okay. So now you see we're making some progress. Can we make this even smaller? Sure thing. How about let's do 1 divided by 0.01. And if you work this out, you get what? You get 100. You pretty much just have to put two zeros after the 1 and you are done. Can we keep going? Sure. Let's do another one. 1 divided by, let's do 0.001. And I just have to put 1 and then 3 zeros after that, we get 1000. And if you just kind of keep going, think about it. We still have the 1, and are we really dividing by 0? Imagine that we are really dividing by 0. What will happen? As you can see, the numbers are just getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. At the end though, it gets to infinity, because that's what the concept of infinity is. You get really, really big, right? Just, it's not number, but it's just meaning really, really big. So that's how they end up with infinity. But let me fix this a little bit. Instead of putting down 1 divided by 0, no, don't do that. This is what we should be doing. We should do 1 divided by 0 with a plus right here, because this right here, we still have a tiny bit amount, right? It's like 0.00000000, like a billion zeros and then 1. This means just a tiny number bigger than 0. If you write this down and say that it's equal to infinity, I'm totally cool with that, right? So maybe I'll come here. That's what exactly they are doing. They are doing some calculus. That's all. And this right here, it's called a limit. Meaning we are looking for how the result will behave if we just keep approaching dividing by 0, just like that. I know Google gives us infinity for the answer. You might be, that's a little bit outrageous, but take a look at Wolfram Alpha. You have infinity with nothing on the top. Complex infinity.